Good morning, everyone. It's lovely to be with you again today. The theme for today is great treasure. The Lord be with you and also with you. As usual, we don't take a collection during this service, but if you'd like to make a donation, I hope you're still continuing to support the church for its ministry, its mission and its maintenance, then you can go to our website. That's www.stpetersburstall.co.uk, or go to the Facebook page at the top and press the Learn More button. Thank you. The kingdom of heaven is radically different from our earthly lives. Today, we seek to learn more of what it means for us now and in the future. Let's pray. God of eternal wisdom, you alone impart the gift of right judgment. Grant us an understanding heart, that we may value wisely the treasure of your kingdom, and gladly forego all lesser gifts to possess that kingdom's incomparable joy, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our reading today is from the Gospel of Matthew, and Dave's reading it to us.
This morning's reading is taken from selected sections of Matthew's Gospel from chapter 13. Jesus told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed, which a man took and planted in his field. Though it is the smallest of all your seeds, yet when it grows, it is the largest of garden plants and becomes a tree, so that the birds of the air come and perch in its branches. He told them still another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a yeast that a woman took and mixed into a large amount of flour, until it worked all through the dough. And another. The kingdom of heaven is like treasure hidden in a field. When a man found it, he hid it again. And then in his joy, went and sold all he had and bought that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant looking for fine pearls. When he found one of great value, he went away and sold everything he had and bought it. Once again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net that was let down into the lake and caught all kinds of fish. When it was full, the fishermen pulled it up on the shore. Then they sat down and collected the good fish in baskets, but threw the bad away. This is how it will be at the end of the age. The angels will come and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Have you understood all these things? Jesus asked. Yes, they replied. He said to them, therefore, every teacher of the law who has been instructed about the kingdom of heaven is like the owner of a house who brings out of his storeroom new treasures as well as old. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Earlier this year, I decided to have a go at baking bread. In fact, I was going to go on a bread-making course as a birthday present, but that didn't happen because of the lockdown. Nevertheless, I persisted and started using a very simple recipe which we found in a National Trust magazine. Two kinds of flour, warm water, a pinch of salt and sugar, and an ounce of butter. And there's something else I've forgotten. Oh, the yeast, of course. In fact, in one of my early attempts, I did forget the yeast, though fortunately I remembered just in time when I was about to leave the dough to rise for the first time. Thankfully, I got away with it and was able to work the yeast into the dough at the last minute. Because without the yeast, it would, of course, have been a complete disaster, as flat as a pancake and as solid as a rock. And yeast, as we have heard, is one of the things that Jesus talks about in our gospel reading from Matthew 13. The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed into a large amount of flour until it worked all through the dough. I've learned two things about the process of getting the yeast to do its work. First, you have to make sure it is worked right into the dough. And second, you have to give it time to rise. This is one of the pictures that Jesus uses to describe the kingdom of heaven. It is like yeast being worked into the dough until the bread rises and is ready for the oven. Now, if you're not careful, you can try to read too much into a parable in which there is usually one key message. But taken together with what Jesus says about the mustard seed starting small and eventually growing into a big tree, this is really about patience. It's about sowing seeds, about working the dough into the yeast, and then waiting patiently for things to happen. Rome wasn't built in a day, and the kingdom of heaven doesn't come in an instant. We need to do the work that God has given us to do, like working the yeast into the dough, and then we need to wait and see what comes. That's the first thing, then. Be patient about what God is doing. The second theme about the kingdom of heaven in this passage has a rather different feel to it. Jesus talks about treasure hidden in a field or a pearl of great value. In this case, the story is about keeping our eye on the prize, about being focused on the ultimate goal, rather than being distracted by what's going on around us or deterred by problems along the way. With all that's going on at the moment with the coronavirus, or indeed all the stuff we have to cope with in our ordinary lives, it is easy to lose sight of the one thing that Jesus wants us to keep in view. In the words of the Sermon on the Mount in Matthew chapter 6, "Seek first the kingdom of heaven, and everything else will be given to you as well." And that gives us the second thing we need to hear from this passage. Stay focused on what God has given you to do. Finally, we come to the third theme in the passage, which comes from this strange little story about fishing nets and keeping the good and throwing away the bad fish that are caught. And that is really about the same theme as last week's gospel reading, namely that we need to leave it to God to sort out the good and the bad at the end of the day. It's a little confusing that the passage we read today has actually been taken out of the middle of the passage we read last week, so that what we read here really belongs together with what Jesus said about harvesting the wheat and the tares. It's for God to sort out what's good and what's bad at the end of the day, not for us. So what does all this mean for us today, in the midst of the coronavirus crisis and as we just tentatively begin to look to the future after the lockdown? Well, as we have seen, the first thing is to do with patience. It's hard at the moment to see what God is doing. We are going to have to wait and see. So we need to get on and do our job, sowing the mustard seed, working the yeast into the dough. It's not exciting. It's about being faithful and keeping faith, knowing that God is at work and that one day we will see the results, like a freshly baked loaf coming out of the oven. The second thing follows from that. We need to keep our eye on the prize, to stay focused on seeking the kingdom of God and not being distracted by worries or wealth or the cares of the world. God is at work, and we need to carry on working with him so that he can use what we offer to help build his kingdom here on earth. And thirdly, we need to leave up to God what he makes of the things that we and others may do. It's not our job to judge what our fellow Christians are doing for the sake of God's kingdom. That is between them and God. Our job is to get on with the work God has given us to do, bringing in the harvest in the field to which he has assigned us. The rest is up to him. As we go through this time of uncertainty and change, we're going to face many challenges. Not everything we used to do as churches will be able to carry on, and some new things that we have learned will have to take their place. What matters is what we have learned and the way in which we respond to what God is bringing. Be patient. God is at work, even when we can't see it. Stay focused on seeking God's kingdom of righteousness and peace. Get on with what God has given us to do and leave the rest up to him. Amen.
And now to the Creed. Please join in. Let us affirm our faith. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. This morning, the music group have been working hard to bring us a song, so listen or join in if you can. The song, Let the King of My Heart.
Let the King of my heart be the mountain where I run, the fountain I drink from, oh, he is my song. Let the King of my heart be the shadow where I hide, the ransom for my life, oh, he is my song. You are good. You are good, good, oh, you are good, good, oh, you are good, good, oh. Let the King of my heart be the wind inside my sails, the anchor in the waves, oh, he is my song. Let the King of my heart be the fire inside my veins, the echo of my days, oh, he is my song. You are good. Never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. 'Cause you are good. You are good. Oh, you are good. Oh, you are good. Oh,
And now to our prayers. Mindful of the teaching of the Lord, let us pray for our needs and the needs of the world. Lord our God, we pray for the victims of discrimination, especially for all people who suffer persecution because of their race, their beliefs, or their circumstances. Help us to become more aware of their suffering and be moved to pray and support them as much as we can. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord our God, we pray for the church and ask that we will never falter in proclaiming the gospel of peace and truth and in enabling people to find the real meaning of life, both in this world and in the world to come. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord our God, we pray for all who are struggling with sickness, stress, and anxiety. We pray that they will find your peace, comfort, and healing in their hearts and in their circumstances this week. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord our God, we pray for our community, our nation, and our world as we face the present pandemic. We give thanks for the selfless commitment of health workers and all those who keep the wheels of society turning. For those who are anxious, bring peace, bring hope. Help us all to be generous and caring in a needy world. May all find comfort and know the strength of your presence. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, our God, hear us as we pray. Let us always look for the things that are in heaven, keeping our eyes on the glorious future you promise us. May our labour be for our good, the good of others, and for the glory of your name. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's join together the prayer that Jesus taught, and we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. And so to the peace. As we share the peace, I'd like you to think of those with whom you would normally share the peace and say the response to me and to them. God calls us to peace. In God's justice is our peace. Christ calls us to be God's people. In Christ is our peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you, and also with you, and you, and you, and you. And now a hymn. I hope you'll join in as the music group leads us in the hymn, Be Thou My Vision.
Be Thou My Vision, O Lord of my heart, be all else but naught to me, save that thou art. Thou my best thought in the day and the night, waking and sleeping, thy presence my light. Be thou my wisdom, be thou my true word, be thou ever presence he prays. Be thou mine inheritance now and always. Be thou and thou only the first in my heart. Sovereign of heaven, thy treasure thou art. Sun, oh grant me its joys after victory is won. Great heart of my own heart, whatever before, still be thou my vision, O ruler of all.
Thank you. And so to our final prayer. Holy Father, you unite us in the fellowship of your Son. May we be united with your people of every race and every language to share in the goodness of your kingdom through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Next week, Annette and I will be sharing together as we come live from our study studio. Of course, if you need any particular help, then please contact us by phone or email us on support@stpetersburstall.co.uk. And most of all, of course, stay safe. And now a blessing. May God give you strength. May God show you mercy. May God fill your heart with love. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and all whom you love, this day and forevermore. Amen. Be in peace. Love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. And so goodbye until next week, and God bless you. Thank you.